Godwin, you beast! Get up! Do you hear me? Wake up, you drunkards!
Oh, fucking hell! Who the hell are you? Oh, Henry. My great friend, Henry. Didn't we have a wonderful time?
Well, you certainly did, you old lecher. Now you better pull yourself together quick. You haven't much time. There's some water and something to eat on the table there, but if I were you, I would move my hairy arse before my flock eats me alive.
Oh, step on in my head. My guts. My poor suffering stomach. What was that woman on about? Before my flock eats me alive. I've forgotten something. What have I forgotten?
Where the fuck am I?
What the fuck was it? Mass! Oh shit, I have to say mass. I gotta say mass. You have to help me.
How? You're the priest.
I can't do it in this state. Maybe the liturgy. But I have to give a sermon as well. Oh, this is a disaster. They're gonna excommunicate me.
I'd like to help you, but...
You can. You can do the sermon for me.
What? So, first I investigate a murder no one wants investigated. Then I drunkenly keep the whole town up all night. And now you want me to preach at them from the pulpit? Do you want them to burn us at the stake?
No. No, I've got it. Suppose it's Sir Ratzig's protege. You just came from studying in Prague. And you want to share the words of Master Jan Hus, who you recently heard preaching there. Henry, look. From what I remember, we might have overdone it a bit last night. And if the bailiff or someone else complains about me, the bishop's gonna have my guts for garters. So I'd appreciate it. Stop gaping at me like a stuffed squirrel and start helping.
You're mad. You're stark raving mad.
I'm not. It's a perfect plan. It's flawless. Oh. How about this? If you help me with this, I'll tell you who Lubosch's cronies are.
So all at once, the confessional seal isn't so sacred?
Don't mock me. I won't give you a second chance.
Well, all right. But I can't make any promises about what'll happen.
No, neither can I.
What do you want me to do, exactly?
I'll go and start the liturgy. Then I'll introduce you. You give the sermon I told you yesterday in the tavern, and that's that. No need to drag it out. If it turns out well, I'll tell you what I know about Lubosch.
Christ almighty. Fine then. We have a deal.
Wonderful. Let's get to it then.
Damn.
Show up. The swill ball.
Look at him. He can hardly walk after his capers last night.
You were with him, you beast. Just you wait.
Look at him. Mother of God. Any minute now, he'll throw up.
So I couldn't sleep a wink last night with all that clamor.
In nomine Patris. Et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Accepit panem in sanctas at venerabiles a manus suas. Hoc facite in meam commemorationem.
Brothers and sisters, you may have had the honor of meeting Henry from Scollets, who is here at the behest of Sir Hanush to investigate that heinous crime at Neuhof. You might not know that Henry recently visited Prague, where, by the grace of God, was able to hear Master Jan Hus from the esteemed Charles University preaching. I've managed to persuade Henry to stand here today in my stead and tell us what he heard. Because, as you all probably know, Jan Hus is a very popular preacher in Prague. So Henry, you may begin.
I wonder what Teresa's doing now. I could stop by and see her again. I enjoyed it last time.
Greetings, brothers and sisters in Christ. I am here to tell you about Mother Church and to show you through my words how she is falling into decay and abandon, how the once great mother of all Christians is losing her dignity and trading in souls like the merchants in the temple. But I am digressing.
That whelp wants to preach about the church.
Creation has given to every man the power by which he might rule the whole world. But that power does not give him the right to rule. That right belongs to God alone. It is the corruption of God's pastors here on earth that has brought misfortune on our heads. Plague, enemies, injustice, hunger and chaos, failed harvests, fires, floods, and other catastrophes. And it is all due to the corrupt servants of God who do not practice what they preach. They think sins can be washed away by money, and they sell indulgences, and that's bad, because sins cannot be redeemed with silver.
Prague didn't do much for his confidence.
And what sins? They live with harlots and keep concubines, even though only marital intercourse for the purpose of procreation is pure. If someone takes a woman or man only to satisfy their own lust, who seduces them to do so but Satan? And how much darker the sin if that man is a servant of the church? Who can turn his face to God, who fornicates and then puts on priestly robes?
Nothing we don't know about already.
Enough about sin, which the prelates are so fond of preaching about, and whose absolution they promise if you pay enough coin to Mother Church. What if the devil himself were to pay? Will the bishops tell us he too would ascend to heaven? And what about those bishops? They sin without remorse, and with the money grasped from the poor for indulgences, they keep fine horses and hordes of servants to pamper them. They play dice and garb their mistresses in expensive furs, while Christ, the Lamb of God, walked barefoot and had nowhere to lay his head. Look to your consciences, you robbers of the poor, for you are seen by God and his people too.
Down with the prelates! Away with them!
We're fortunate to have our good father Godwin. At least he's a fair and simple man.
God sees what is happening on earth, and he is filled with righteous wrath that those who should seek the salvation of souls instead seek mammon and the idle comfort of lucrative posts. Blessed are the shepherds who share the poverty of their flock, who are as one with you and bear with you the burden of this earthly pilgrimage, who do not condemn your venial sins.
Aye, all honour to Godwin. Let him drink like one of us.
That is all I heard in Prague. Amen.
Have you no shame, you pair of buffoons? I'll be writing to the bishop of this. For shame.
Utterly blasphemous.
Can you believe such behavior? For men of the cloth to get drunk at...
So, is our deal still on?
Are you pulling my fucking pizzle? I couldn't have done worse myself if I'd puked on the altar.
Well, I'm no preacher.
Yeah, I noticed. And I wasn't the only one.
You can't be serious. After all that...
All what? All you making a complete hash of my sermon? You were supposed to help, not get me into even more trouble. Now I'll have the bishop on my back, and all the villagers. Just leave, I need to pull myself together.
And what am I supposed to do?
Find someone else to help you.
Good day to you. What do you need? Good luck, then.
All the saints were watching over me. Thank you.
God be with you. What can I do for you?
God be with you. What can I do for you?
Let's talk about the price.
Well, we can try it.
Aye, that would do it.
What I've got for you. You'll love this.
Fresh from the fields.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Godwin won't tell me who Lubosch's cronies were. I've reached a complete standstill.
Don't even mention that so-called priest. He knocked out one of my teeth yesterday, and you were there with him. I ought to clap you in the stocks.
I'll go willingly if you stick Godwin next to me. It'd be worth it just to see him suffer.
I can well imagine. I've already told you, nobody came here to see him. But now it occurs to me, I did hear he was tried in Ratte for some mischief or other. Maybe you can find out something there. The scribe might have made a record of it.
Thanks, Bailiff. I never thought of that.
And let me give you another piece of advice. Don't go boozing with Godwin again.
Good health to you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
All right, so.
agree?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. See now, I knew we'd come to an agreement.
God be with you. Do you need anything?
God bless.
Look out.
Thank you.
Hey!
Good boy. That's my boy.
Who's there?
Well, I never.
Good day to you.
Is there someone here who can compete with me in archery?
Sure. There's always arrows flying here. First, I'll explain the rules to you. You shoot 7, 13, or 21 arrows, depending on who you're shooting against. The straw surround is worth 1 point, the white ring 2, and the bullseye 3. Whoever finishes shooting first gets 3 extra points. The round ends when everyone is finished shooting, and whoever has the most points wins. It's the custom to wager on it, to make it more interesting, see? The better the archers you shoot against, the higher the stakes.
All right, that seems straightforward.
Just one more thing. Don't leave while the contest is underway, and never aim or shoot at anything but the target. Otherwise, you're out. Got it?
Got it.
How good are you with a bow? So I can find you a suitable opponent.
I'm a beginner.
Doesn't matter. At least you'll get a bit of practice. Beginners shoot 7 arrows a round. Splendid! Here's some arrows for you. But you can use your own if you want. Meanwhile, I'll round up the competition. You may shoot! Contest over, archers!
Hey, you're not allowed to walk around here with a weapon drawn. Put it away. Is there someone here who compete with me in archery?
Of course. What do you think this range is for? How good are you with a bow? So I can find you a suitable opponent. God be with you.
Is there someone here who compete with me in archery?
Of course. What do you think this range is for? How good are you with a bow? So I can find you a suitable opponent.
I'm a beginner.
Doesn't matter. At least you'll get a bit of practice. Beginners shoot 7 arrows a round. Splendid! Here's some arrows for you. But you can use your own if you want. Meanwhile, I'll round up the competition. Victor is Henry. Contest over.
day to you. May the Lord watch over you.
God be with you.
Is there anything suspicious going on in these parts?
Indeed there is. Just last night, Father Godwin was here, calling fire and brimstone down on old Gertrude, the herb woman. He's not one to make a fuss over some trifle either. Farewell.
Greetings. What do you need?
You live here?
Of course.
I mean here, in the presbytery.
Yeah, right here.
In the presbytery? With the parish priest?
Yes. What's the matter? Don't you like me?
Yes, of course I like you.
So why are you surprised Godwin likes me too?
I'm not. I mean, I see. I think.
Good luck then.
Do you have any work that needs doing?
My dear lad, I have more worries than I can bear. Another pair of shoulders would ease my burden. I have to deal with a local witch.
A witch?
The herb woman. Old Gertrude, that devious hag who will stoop to anything, like all herbalists for that matter.
Oh, don't tell me. The cows are giving blood instead of milk,
and babies are being born with two heads and a tail.
This is no laughing matter. Gertrude isn't evil. She just has peculiar ideas about what's good for people. A little bird told me she incited some Ujet's women to witchery.
A little bird told you, did it?
You know how good people are at seeing the splinter in another's eye and not the beam in their own.
In other words, someone's been gossiping. And what's the problem?
As long as herb women stick to giving psychic to folk and bloated cows, assisting in childbirth, or burning incense in bedrooms to help with sleep, then nothing at all. But this is sacrilege, and it's unsafe. All sorts of molds and lichens and poisonous plants and other foul things go into those concoctions. I'd hate to see her poison some poor gullible lass.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to go and see her and find out what she's been up to. I know she lives in fear of the Holy Church, so tell her I sent you. That will make her talk and think twice about encouraging witchcraft. If you learn that she truly did involve folk in some foolishness, find out all you can and deal with it.
Consider it done.
Good. And never fear. I'm a man who always pays his debts. You'll find Gertrude, the old herb woman, in the woods. God be with you.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Greetings. What do you need?
I've come in the name of Sir Hanish of Leiper. I'm investigating the massacre in Neuhof, and now a murder here as well. Can I ask you a few questions?
Ask all you want, lad.
Who was this Lubosch who was murdered?
Those that live by the sword die by the sword. I'm not surprised the end he came to.
Have you noticed anything suspicious recently?
Everything about him was suspicious. I always gave him a wide berth.
Do you know what Lubosch was doing the day Neuhof was raided?
How would I know?
Do you know who Lubosch used to spend time with? Kin or friends?
I don't know, since I don't go to alehouses.
That's all. Thank you.
I've come from the priest. They're saying you incited some women to witchcraft.
Me? Witchcraft? That's nothing but idle chatter.
You'd be wise to give me a straight answer. I mean you no harm.
As long as it's the truth you speak. Very well. I'll tell you everything. I've done a very foolish thing. It's preying on my mind so much I can't sleep a wink.
But I'm supposed to believe an old witch has pangs of conscience.
Laugh if you like, but it's not a word of a lie. You probably know I sell various magic lotions and potions alongside my herbs. Well, there's one I wish I hadn't sold. You see, Vera, Zlata, and Khuta from Uzhitz wanted a magic ointment from me. I kept refusing them, but in the end, I let them talk me into it.
What kind of ointment was it?
One that will show you a world no one else can see. A place of wonder and terror. The flowers might start talking to you, or the earth could swallow you up. I don't know if it's the work of the devil or of God himself, but the ointment has that power. But it could poison any person who doesn't know how to use it right.
So all this talk of witches anointing themselves and then flying to their sabbaths on broomsticks.
The ointment could make a person see such things. But it was stupid of me letting those foolish women get their hands on it. They could poison themselves or fall off a cliff while they're lost in a dream.
Will you give me the ointment recipe?
It contains belladonna and the herb Paris, both quite poisonous plants. That ought to make you think twice about dabbling with it.
So why did you give them the ointment at all?
Because I'm soft-hearted. You see, one of those women, Vera, lost her whole family in Skalitz. And Zlata's husband was killed. And the youngest of them, Khuta, miscarried with the horror of it all. They said they wanted to use the ointment to speak with the dead and ask them to put a word in with the Lord.
I understand how they feel. But I reckon it'll get them nowhere but the ducking stool and the stake.
Judge not, lest ye be judged. I didn't want to give them the ointment, but they offered me a pile of groschen. So I thought how desperate they must be, and I heard their plea.
Their plea, or the clink of their coin? And why are you so worried about them all of a sudden? What changed your mind?
I'm losing sleep over it. Firstly, those women don't know what they're doing. And secondly, folk might see it as witchcraft. And do you know what they do to witches?
They burn them alive.
That they do. So don't be surprised I'm worried.
It didn't bother you before, though. What did they want the ointment for?
Each one of them lost a loved one recently, and it's grieving them. They wanted to talk with the dead.
I've heard enough.
If you've heard enough, you must understand why I need your help. Find out from those women what they intend, and watch over them to keep them safe.
Very well. But only because the priest himself asked me to.
Thank you a thousandfold. I'll go to the Reverend myself and explain. You take care of those women. May the Lord watch over you.
Yeah!
Good evening. Take care. Hey.
Deaf.
I've heard something about a magical ointment.
Really? I'd like to know where from. And what concern is it of yours, anyway?
The priest is worried.
The priest? It's nice to find out what telltales you have for neighbors. But believe me, it's none of your business, or the priest's.
It could be dangerous. Not just for your soul, that shit is poisonous.
So I'm supposed to believe the herb woman slipped us poison instead of the ointment?
She'd like to know what you plan to do with it, and when.
But we already told her. I don't understand why she'd get you involved in it. Why don't you just leave us alone?
What are you doing here? Get lost or you'll have me to reckon with.
God! Huh.
Are you deaf? What the hell are you fooling about here for? Be off right now or I'll fucking see. Look out!
What's the matter with you?
Is there something new?
What are you up to? Get out of here!
Jesus Christ be praised. I'd like you to show me how to ride a horse better.
Certainly.
Well, I'll think it over.
May the Lord watch over.
God be with you. What can I do for you?
Could do with a bite to eat.
What's that? Is there something you need? Mother of God, you look like you've been assaulted. Goodbye.
Is there somewhere I could sleep here?
Certainly. For how long?
Just the one night.
Sure, but groschen first. These are harsh times.
That's quite a lot. Can we discuss the price? What do you say to this?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. You've got it all to yourself. No one will disturb you.
Where do I go to sleep?
You'll have no trouble finding it. Right inside the door to the building, there's a ladder up to the loft. Your bed's ready there, and a trunk for your belongings. Goodbye.
I heard something about a magic ointment that you got from the herbalist.
You're heard that where? And what business is it of yours?
The priest is concerned.
The priest can go to hell. All he cares about is filling his belly. And then that bastard talks down to us from the pulpit about temperance and humility. It's because of his sort, the lords and the humans here that killed my husband and children. Where was the priest then, eh?
I don't quite know what's going on, but I'll find out one way or another. So I'd suggest you start talking.
Look, there's no need to make threats. There's nothing going on. Well, maybe a few spells and such, but nothing that could harm folk. We mean well, I swear. Our souls are our own concern. God has forsaken us, and we have to fend for ourselves.
Hey, who's there?
Jesus!
What's going on out? What's that?
I've heard something about a magical ointment.
What? Who told you that? Was someone asking around?
It might interest the priest.
The priest? Who's been telling him stories? Does he know about us?
What I've heard already amounts to a burning offense.
Wait. Really?
If someone buys witching ointment, what am I supposed to think they want it for? Let me take a wild guess. Witchcraft. And witches deserve to burn.
We're doing no wrong. We go to the woods alone, at night, and we hurt no one. I won't say any more. You might twist it against us.
God be with you.
Is there someone here who compete with me in archery?
Of course. What do you think this range is for? How good are you with a bow? So I can find you a suitable opponent.
I'm a beginner.
Doesn't matter. At least you'll get a bit of practice. Beginners shoot 7 arrows a round. Splendid! Here's some arrows for you. But you can use your own if you want. Meanwhile, I'll round up the competition. Take care. Contest is over. Henry here is the winner.
Cheap and does a good solid job. You take my advice, talk to Raymond, and leave Yuckum be.
I'll bear it in mind.
Hey, who's there?
God be with you. What can I do for you?
God bless.
Anything else? What's it to be?
Jesus Christ, your clothes. Were you assaulted? Damn bandits, may they burn in hell.
Is there somewhere I could sleep here?
All right. For how long?
Just the one night.
All right. Money up front, though.
That's quite a lot. Can we discuss the price? What do you say to this?
You're a right pinch purse. Take care.
Have you got a bed for the night?
Aye, there's room here. For how long?
Just the one night.
All right. Money up front, though.
That's quite a lot. Can we discuss the price? What about this?
Come now, just a little more and we have a deal.
Are we agreed?
Well now, a little more and we'll shake on it. You've got it all to yourself. No one will disturb you. Take care.
Can we do something about the price?
Well, we can try it.
Since it's you.
Well now, A little more, and we'll shake on it. All right, so.
Wait here for me. Stay.
We're all here. We can set off.
Is it far?
Not at all. But we should put the ointment on now. It takes a while to start working.
Where exactly do you put it on?
Well, there. You know?
I feel shy.
So playing games with the devil is all right, but dabbing some ointment on your cunny is going too far.
Aye. Well, don't peek for a bit. I'm not sure.
Don't worry. Plenty of women have tried it before us.
What if it does work? What if he does appear?
But that's what we want, isn't it? Let's go.
we're here. We all know what to do, don't we?
I'm not altogether sure. Gertrude didn't want to say anything, I'm glad. So all we know is what we came up with ourselves. Dear, I feel old, peculiar.
The ointment is the main thing, and we'll think up some chant or two.
Just let's get it over with.
Like Gertrude said, why is it getting so dark? It's very loud. Make them stop, at least for a while, please. My head hurts. Lucifer, star of the morning, we're here to ask you a boon.
What is it? Girls, I feel the devil is coming. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death.
What are you praying to the Virgin Mary? You scare the devil away.
Stop praying and speak for death. Silly frightens we've lost our own.
Satan, appear and send pestilence on all of humans. I'm coming to meet you.
Who is it? Who's there?
Just me. I haven't found anyone. Who's me?
You're Lucifer, aren't you?
Thank you for heeding our call. Send the plague down on Sigismund and his humans.
It's me, Vera.
I think so. Everything's mortal. Lucifer, deliver us from the humans. A plague upon them and their families. Lord God, you turned your back on us in our hour of need. We beg you. At least now command Lucifer to rid us of the humans!
Yes, Lucifer, deliver us of the humans! Here and now, come among us! Take what you want and let Sigismund and the humans die of the plague like mangy dogs! They killed our husbands and children! Let them die! Let them go back whence they came, back to hell!
Come, Satan!
Take us! Ashna, do you hear that? There really is somebody in those bushes.
Come among us! You there? Are you Lucifer?
It doesn't matter who you are.
Come here!
You dreamt it.
O Prince of Exiles! You who the world has treated wrong!
I hear someone coming. Who's there? Is it you, Khuta?
No, I'm still over here.
What's going on here?
Welcome, Prince of Darkness. And make yourself at home.
What would you like us to do? We will fulfill your every wish. If you fulfill ours.
Prince of Darkness, what in God's name are you babbling about?
Why are you testing us?
Testing you? Jesus Christ, what have you been smearing on yourselves?
A magic ointment from the herb woman? We are ready to pleasure you, Lord. In return, all we ask is that you rid us of the humans. And if you won't rid us of them, then help us get away from here. Give us riches, so we can start a new life in the city.
I won't be fulfilling any of your wishes.
Oh. What must we do to please you, O Lord?
In return, you'll have to...
Shit.
I feel very weird.
Oh, that ointment. You smeared the ointment on me.
Fear not, my lord. Nothing will happen to you. It's all part of the ceremony.
Oh, shit. What the fuck? What did you do to me?
Are you quite well after your long journey?
Huh? Long journey? What?
From the gates of hell to here. When will you take care of the humans? And why don't you have horns and hooves and a goat's tail, like the priest said?
I got rid of my horns and hooves along the way, and I keep my tail in my breeches. I only get it out for special occasions.
I hope there'll be one soon enough.
How come you're a talking mare?
What mare? Does your sight deceive you? I'm Vera, and I turn many a young man's head in Ujits.
I flew in on a tree branch. It took no time at all.
Flying on a branch? Will you teach us how to do that too? We are your mate servants now. We'll do anything you wish.
Actually, I wanted something else.
What's that, O Lord?
Will you serve me and do all I tell you to?
Oh yes, our Lord of Hellfire. We'll do whatever you want. Just rid us of those wretched humans. Which one will you take first?
Me. Take me.
No. Me.
And what about the other one? Why doesn't she speak up?
Khuta, you chicken! Speak up!
I want you, Mare. Vera.
I knew it. Come on. Come closer to me.
That was tough. Oh, but I'm all dizzy again.
What is wrong with you? Is something going to come of it or not?
I need to sleep.
Bugger sleep! What was that? What is it? Someone coming!
All right, now you're dead!
fuck happened here? Shit!
Oh my god. These are no demons, just flesh and blood woodcutters.
I'll never be able to explain this to anyone. A fucking ointment. Damn that old hag. Now what?
Heel. Yeah.
Where the hell were you brought up? Don't you know you have to have a light?
I found out more about the Ujit's witchcraft.
Pray, do tell.
The women have got hold of some magic lotion from the herb woman, and they're using it to summon the devil.
For the love of heaven.
I followed them to where they held their Sabbath. They summoned the devil, danced around a fire.
Oh my God, what else?
The women were completely out of their minds from that ointment. Then some woodcutters stormed in. They wanted to put a stop to the witch's Sabbath.
Good God. And what happened?
I had to kill the woodcutters to save those women from them.
For Christ's sake! How could you? Such needless slaughter! Those men meant well. Was there no other way to stop the bloodshed?
The woodcutters were beside themselves with rage, baying for the women's blood. There was no reasoning with them.
There must have been another way.
I did everything I could.
The good Lord observes your deeds. Pray for the souls of those unfortunate Christians. Pray, because you have blood on your hands. At least you see where dancing with the devil can take you. Pray for their loved ones and for your soul and mine, because we share the blame. And now please, go. Leave me alone to pray.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
keselít. Véletlenül kibújtál az anyád szoknyája alól.
Come along, free.
been around like a foot bag. Everyone has to carry it.
I found out more about the Ujit's witchcraft.
Pray, do tell.
The women have got hold of some magic lotion from the herb woman, and they're using it to summon the devil.
For the love of heaven.
I followed them to where they held their Sabbath. They summoned the devil, danced around a fire.
Oh my God, what else?
The women were completely out of their minds from that ointment. Then some woodcutters stormed in. They wanted to put a stop to the witch's Sabbath.
Good God. And what happened?
I had to kill the woodcutters to save those women from them.
For Christ's sake! How could you? Such needless slaughter! Those men meant well. Was there no other way to stop the bloodshed?
The woodcutters were beside themselves with rage, baying for the women's blood. There was no reasoning with them.
There must have been another way.
I did everything I could.
The good Lord observes your deeds. Pray for the souls of those unfortunate Christians. Pray, because you have blood on your hands. At least you see where dancing with the devil can take you. Pray for their loved ones and for your soul and mine, because we share the blame. And now please, go. Leave me alone to pray.
God be with you.
Yeah. 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 Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Jesus Christ, your clothes! Were you assaulted? Damn bandits, may they burn in hell!
I was at the Ujit's Women's Sabbath.
And how did it turn out?
The women were making such a ruckus, the woodcutters took them for witches and burst in on them. They meant to kill them.
Jesus Christ. And how did it end?
I killed them all.
Killed them? God Almighty. You killed the men who went to see what all the noise was about?
Well, I didn't have much of a choice. There was no talking with them. They were determined to kill the witches. I'm so sorry.
Holy Mother of God, you're my witness. I meant no harm. Forgive my sins and have mercy on me in my final hour. And as for you, you'd better go.
Goodbye.